Again, we mentioned earlier the third part, when you become the speaker that you want to be, it's all about your audience. Always, no matter what you're talking about it. Your people are sitting in your audience and they turn into that the old radio station that they say, WIIFM, which stands for What's in It for Me. That's all they're doing. They're sitting in your audience wondering, why am I here and what's in it for me? So make sure that you know what's in it for your audience when you're delivering it and what's going on. You got to connect with your audience. You and we. When you're speaking to an audience, if I say, I do this and I've done that and I do this, people are like, I, enough of this. But if I say you and we can do this together and you have the, if you would like to be a public speaker, there's things we can do together to make that happen. But if I say, if you want to be a public speaker and I can make that happen for you, yeah, that's a total different thing that we could work together and make it happen. So really, you turn it out, the eyes should always be you and we as much as possible. That's how you include an audience. You, we can do this together. Share a good laugh, always fun, make people chuckle. Make people groan. Humor isn't what you think. It doesn't have to be a joke. It doesn't have to be over the top funny. It could be a little quip, something going on, what's going on. Throw it in there. Ask questions. Great way to get audience interaction is just that simple little thing by a show of hands. By a show of hands, how many of you today drove here? Right? So we get everybody, geez, now I got you, you're involved, you're going with it. By a show of hands, how many people use video? Right? If you're out there presenting and you want to talk to people, that's how you get it. So by a show of hands, how many people have a YouTube page? So now you got people. Now you got them involved, right? This is what I'm saying. By a show of hands, how many people have gone to Sandler training? You know, and you just ask in the room, what's going on? How many, by a show of hands, how many of you have given a presentation in public? Nice. Inform them that they're about to tell them the next is very important. So a good way about this, the next statement I'm about to make is so profound, and you just stop. The next statement I'm about to make is so profound, just stop and deliver your next statement. But tell the audience that you've got this tremendous, profound thing coming so they know and they're waiting, and then we can tell them whatever you want. Mr. Softy's down a block, run down, get an ice cream cone, whatever you want to do. They're all yours. They're all yours after that. This is one thing I'd like to discuss. Maybe you could. I'm glad you're here. Do you quiz the audience?
Yes.
You do? Yeah. See, I don't quiz the audience.
But I'm a trainer.
Yeah. Yeah. So
it's different.
So let me throw out one thing that you would quiz an audience about. I find that interesting. I really wanted to know because I don't quiz the audience. So I know it's in there as part of the things you should do and get audience. So what would you ask them?
Stuff that I've taught them in the past to see if they got it, if they could connect it up.
So you mean literally like quiz them on what they're learning? Like, hey, you better learn, guys, because there's a quiz after this. Is that what you're saying?
Not really, no. No, when I say quiz, I'm asking them questions.
Right.
So just to see if they
got
it.
Yeah.
You know, on a regular basis.
Yeah, I guess that's what it comes to, just quizzing the audience instead of really giving them a quiz. Like that. Maybe it's my stinking thinking telling me I don't want to ever take another quiz in my life. You know, I wasn't very good at them. So go out into the audience as much as possible. You know, make them feel if I come over here and we're talking now, it's very personal. It's very personal. We can see what's going on and we come over here. Norman, how's that computer coming? All right, buddy? So what we're going to do is we learned some things. We're going to go back. We're going to have some fun. Gestures, hand gestures. Someone asked me earlier, what do you do with your hands when you're not using them? Who asked that question? I'm sorry, was it you, Emily? What do you do with your hands when you're not using them? There's a different ways to do things with your hands. There's a lot of people who do the spider on the mirror. You ever see that? They're like, I was out the other night and I if this isn't a distraction, nothing is. Hey, doing push-ups on the mirror. Hey, yeah. All right, so that's one way. Some people do this. So you can see that you'll see speakers. They'll come out and how is everyone? You know, really, how you? You know what this means? This means, my God, I'm scared. Please stay away. Please, 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 please get back. Yeah, it's like so. Really, what you do with your hands is you just drop them. You just drop them. Here works fine. Right here. By your sides is terrific, but this is a little formal. You know, it's a little formal, like, hey, how are you? Here's good, because now you can go from here to here and use a gesture. So from here to here, use a gesture. Here to here, pointing at your PowerPoint, so like right over here, you know, gestures. They're very important. Pointing things out, don't overuse them. I was joking earlier, we're from New Jersey, so we get to overuse them. People understand it. Like, hey, what's going on? You know, you can do whatever you want with your hands. But literally, this becomes too much. There's too much going on. You become the focal point of what, how are you, you know, so, you know, just drop your hands down, talk naturally. You wouldn't do this if you were talking to your buddy, right? Hey, what's going on? You want to go out for a pizza?
Sure.
There we go. Yeah, be prepared. Know your topic. Be confident in your topic. Then you'll become more confident in yourself. And understand, start to realize that you're giving a talk. Prepare, practice, do it over and over again. Really what happens is if you know what you're going to say, it gets a lot easier. I've been doing this over and over and over again, this presentation, for the last year and a half or so, maybe 2 years. So it just comes now and I just go out and I do it. At first I would be like, you know, I didn't know what to say, what to do, and then it just happens. And it really is, just keep, the only thing I can say is if you want to speak in public, get your business out there, let people know about you. Then practice, practice, practice. It's very important. Would you agree? People need to know with clarity when they leave, when you speak with them, what you do and who you are. They need to know that. Because if not, you're just one of those cards that somebody flips and we all have a desk full of them, right? That nobody stood out. Who was this guy? I have no idea. Who was this gal? I have no idea. You want to be the person that somebody wrote on their card? I got to meet with her. And that's through public speaking. I'd like to say thank you, Chris. Thank you for the opportunity. My pleasure. Thank you, guys. You're the best. Awesome. Enjoy the rest of your week.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.